Hi, this is John. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Hey, how are you? Is your name John as well?
It is John.
How are you?
I'm fine, John. I've been a fan of yours for a long time. I've watched your television programs, and I've gone to a couple of your seminars. So.
Thank you. How can I help you tonight, John?
Well, I'd like to connect with some people that have passed over.
That's pretty much what I do for a living. So if there was one relationship or a person that you were hoping to hear from, who would that be? And the reason why anybody that's calling tonight, or if we're going to be Skyping with you, here's what I want you to know. The reason why I'm going to specifically say to you what's the relationship of the person that you want to connect with is very, very simple. I want to make sure that you're listening to what I'm saying. And what winds up happening is every single person that calls up with the hope of hearing from one or two specific people. And then what winds up happening is I wind up connecting with what I get. And you try to apply it to what you want, and then you're going to tell me no. And it might not make sense for the person you're hoping to hear from, but it might make sense for the person who's coming through if you're listening to what's happening. So, John, what's the relationship of someone that you would like or hope for me to connect with?
Mother.
Okay. Now, here's a great example of why I do that. I'm not actually getting your mom, but I do want to take you to a male contemporary. Is there somebody that I would see as being like a friend to you who's crossed?
Yeah.
Like, you understand this?
Yeah.
Okay, and has this person been gone in the last 5 years?
Within the last 5 years?
Yeah, because I need to go back 5 years. That's something about the last 5 years.
Yes.
Okay, is that when the person passed? Like, passed in the last 5 years?
Yes.
Okay, do you know if their father's passed? Because I'm getting the feeling of being with dad.
It makes sense.
Because I'm supposed to say that the person's with dad. I'm with dad.
Okay.
Just let me know if you understand what I'm saying, because I feel like I'm playing hot and cold, and I don't play hot and cold. You either do have it or you don't have it. So you do have a friend who's passed?
I do have a friend
okay.
that's passed.
And he does have, or this friend does have, a older male who's crossed as well?
No, the friend that I'm thinking of,
Well, the friend that's coming through has a father figure who's there. There's somebody there who had a 1-2-3 passing, like a cardiac arrest or like something 1-2-3. They were here and then they were gone. The month of April, by the way, John, has a meaning, either birthday or anniversary. Goes to tell me to talk to you about the 4. So either the 4th month, April, or the 4th of a month has some type of meaning, either birthday or anniversary. And I need to really stress that the energy that's coming through loudest for me is the one to the side. So I know you might have wanted me to connect with your mom. I'm sorry I'm not making the connection there, but I am making the connection with the person to the side. And that to me would be like the friend, the husband, the brother, that energy.
Okay.
And that friend is insisting that I tell you that I have the father figure who's there. So either your dad or his dad has passed.
That makes sense.
And do you know the person that passed 1-2-3 from the heart attack? It's connected here as well.
The 1-2-3, well, that would make sense.
Okay. Now, why is April so important? Because they keep going back to the 4.
Gosh. I'm not sure. Because
let me help you. Whose birthday is in April?
Of the people that I know.
No. John, connect it to you. Whose birthday? Who around you has a birthday in April?
No one of my immediate family I can think of.
Okay, I want to highlight April 10th, April 11th, right around that period of time as being something that would be significant. To me, I'm looking at this as being congratulatory, so whether it be a birthday or something that would be a celebration, it's right soon as we get into like double digits, like the 10th, the 11th. So it's like right around that period of time.
But I do know somebody that passed in my family whose birthday was, I believe, like the 11th or the 12th of April.
And this person's passed?
Yes.
Okay.
But it's a female figure.
That's fine. And if that's their birthday, that could be their way of, or acknowledging their way in, because it anchors us to their energy. Do you follow? I don't know what's coming up for you in September, but apparently the 9th month is going to be interesting in your family. So I don't know what kind of shifts and changes are taking place around you then, or what might be coming up, but I always tell people to embrace the change and challenges and the transitions that come up with an open mind, and to be excited about what the outcome can bring. And sometimes changes and transitions can be very challenging because people get a reaction of fear. It elicits, like, you know, a feeling of imbalance to what we know. Just sit tight and kind of allow it to kind of unfold in front of you.
You think good change or bad change?
You know, did you see the movie Kung Fu Panda?
No.
Okay. I have a young son, big fan of Kung Fu Panda. And there's one scene when the gentleman, one of the characters says, "I have bad news." And the older, wise, sage character says, "There's no such thing as bad news. There's just news." And I laughed because perspective is really key here. So is the change good or is the change bad? It really doesn't matter. It means how is it affecting for you? Because sometimes if somebody loses a lot of weight, that change would be positive for them regarding their health, correct?
Correct.
But the struggle to get there, the having to diet, the having to maybe stop eating the foods you like, or having to go to a gym or do all that kind of stuff, that aspect of it, maybe not so fun. So it's really the perspective of what we're seeing here. John, is your dad not around?
Correct.
Okay, because I'm not getting a feeling of a father figure. So I don't know. And when I say not around, I mean like not present in your life, correct?
Correct.
Okay. I feel like there's something about you kind of coming to terms or grips or understanding, or maybe you're at a point in your life where you're now kind of, you've wrestled with the relationship stuff with dad for a long time. And
sure.
And the fact that you feel like mom is gone, or the lack of mom, or the issue of mom being out of your life as well, kind of puts the spotlight on you in a certain way. Do you know what I'm saying?
I do.
Okay. And I feel like that's where some of the change kind of comes in. And I feel like, you know, one of the things that, you know, it's so funny, I've been having conversations about this. You know, I think technology is phenomenal. Clearly, look what we're doing. We're talking live, you know, via the internet, and you're in one state, I'm in a different state, and we're not doing this like on TV, which is what people would normally, you know, kind of connect with on stuff like this. But here's the deal. We're doing this because of technology. But the positive side, and talk about perspective again, the positive side is that, you know, we have growth and we have opportunity and we have, you know, social networking sites. But the negative side is that people live their lives outside of themselves. They Twitter and they Facebook and they MySpace, and they live their existence out here for everybody to see and experience. And sometimes it allows them to comment on what it is, you know. And I feel like a little bit of that for you. It's like some of your life was lived outside of yourself family-wise. Like you created your circle of friends and family as friends and family, not as biological. Do you understand what I mean by that?
I do.
Okay. And as a result of that, I feel like you've allowed other people to either, I don't want to use the word pass judgment, maybe help to shape or define how certain things can be. And I feel like our connecting today is to achieve a certain level of balance. So when it goes back to the thing about September, whatever the shifts and changes happen in September, just be positive, be realistic. And I feel like the goals that you're setting, awesome, set them, but make sure that they're attainable, you know? And I feel like, don't worry about the dad stuff. And I mean this with respect. Don't worry about the mom stuff. Worry about the John stuff. And worry about what's happening with where you're living and what's happening in the living arrangements and what's around you and all that kind of stuff. Alrighty?
Okay.
Thanks, John.
Okay, thank
Good
you
luck.
So much.
You're welcome.